As you probably already heard, much of the United States was recently battling an extreme cold snap. And coupled with poor management of the power system, this forced many Americans off the power grid and tragically cost many Americans their lives. And of course, naturally, we want to know how an event like this fits into the big picture. We want to know how it fits into climate change, and we want to know how it fits into our energy transition. When I've seen people asking and answering these questions, one idea has come to mind more than almost any other: confirmation bias. Confirmation bias is the notion that we're more likely to accept new information if that new information confirms the beliefs we already hold. Okay, but what does this have to do with climate change? Well, it means that often when we hear what's happening to our planet, we're actually just hearing what we want to hear. Now let's look at how this affected how we spoke about the extreme cold in parts of America like Texas. For those who already disapproved of renewables, this just served as evidence of renewables' failures. In fact, wind was primarily blamed for the failures of the power system in Texas, even though, spoiler alert, wind was not primarily to blame. Other parts of the power system lost a lot more capacity during the cold spike than wind or solar did. But that didn't stop many American conservatives talking ad infinitum about wind turbines. For more on this, check out this excellent video from Climate Town. And if you spend much of your time on climate change Twitter, which I obviously do, then you may well have come across this image. Now, this image was actually taken in 2014 in Sweden, so unless the atmosphere has somehow learnt to time travel, I'm pretty sure it has nothing to do with the recent power outages in Texas. Okay, but what about the climate change side of this catastrophe? Well, as I'm sure you're used to by now, whenever cold hits, there are those who say that that somehow disproves climate change. After all, cold is the opposite of warm. Take that, scientists. This science denial technique is, of course, a favorite of Donald Trump, who has used it time and time again. But look, here's what the science actually says. Global warming is about what it says it's about. It's about the average warming of the globe. Just because the globe is on average warming, that doesn't mean cold stops existing. It doesn't mean winter stops existing. What you would expect it to mean, though, is that winters would, on average, keep getting warmer, and yes, that is what we're seeing for pretty much all of the United States. So this event confirmed a lot of the biases of those opposed to renewable energy, or of those who deny climate science. But here's the thing, confirmation bias works both ways. You see, some people have been stating that this weird winter weather has climate change's fingerprints all over it, and that a warmer world has actually made cold extremes like this more likely. Now, there is actually a reason that people are suggesting this, and it's because the Arctic is heating much faster than the rest of the planet. That lowers the temperature difference between the Arctic and lower latitudes, and some scientists suggest that this could potentially mean that cold Arctic air finds it easier to escape further south, triggering these kinds of cold snaps. But notice that I said some scientists, and I also said potentially, because you see, the jury is still out. There isn't enough observational evidence at this stage to say clearly one way or the other, and on top of that, efforts to computer simulate the atmospheric dynamics at play fail to really confirm this mechanism. I honestly think it's going to be hard to conclusively link this to climate change or not until we have more observations over more time. But, as you may have seen, many have discussed this extreme cold as if it's a clear-cut symptom of climate change. And I think at least a part of the reason for that is down to confirmation bias. You see, for those of us who understand that climate change is happening and that it's man-made and all of that, it can be tempting to see signs of it in every extreme weather event, even when that's not yet backed up by the science. Okay, so we all have biases that we want to confirm, whether that's about wind turbines or winter weather. But at the same time, I think there are some things that we know for sure. Whether a disaster is driven by climate change or not, what's disastrous about them is always, in some ways, human-caused. That's because we know we get extreme weather. The problem comes when governments and industries fail to prepare for this extreme weather. So when disaster strikes, they fail to evacuate people and they fail to keep the lights on. And the truth is that thanks to climate change, many types of extreme weather events, from heat waves to downpours, are getting more extreme and are getting more frequent. So if our governments can't adequately respond to the disasters of today, what does that say about the extreme weather we'll be suffering in the future? Wait, before you go anywhere, there are two videos that I really think you should see. The first is that Climate Town video that I mentioned, all about the nonsense about wind turbines in Texas. And the second is a video from Simon Clark, all about the polar vortex and how it is, or maybe isn't, affecting our weather. I put links to them in the description of this video and also in the pinned comment. Okay, until next time, bye. Like that.